Hello, these are the announcements for Sunday, August 30th, the 13th Sunday after Pentecost. As you are almost certainly aware, we have resumed in-person public worship. We had our first church services outdoors at Nelsonville last week on the 23rd. It went really well. I don't know the exact numbers because people were coming as I was already up leading the service, but somewhere like 70 people came to the first service and somewhere like 20 came to the second service. People were really good about masking. People were really good about keeping distance during the service. And people were really good about staying in their bubbles. So if you've been thinking that maybe you'd come but you didn't know how it was going to play out, people were very cognizant of the needs of our most vulnerable, and you should come if you think it's safe. Now, there are another couple of options there that no one exploited. We have a yellow rope line with pink streamers hanging from it, and you can park right up against that facing the front, and you could stay in your car, actually, if you thought that was safer. The loudspeakers should get plenty of signal to you in the car. There's also an elevated part up to the preacher's left. So as you're looking at me, it'd be up to your right behind Nelsonville. Nobody sat there, and you could have a space that is pretty much yours up there. With 70 people, the shade that was available was taken, but everyone managed to be in shade. So if we have more than that this week, it might be good for you to bring an umbrella along. Umbrellas are not just good for rain, they're good for shade as well. And I hope that as you feel safe, you'll resume your habit of attending public worship. Again, we're going to continue doing this for the foreseeable future. And so you have options, your church is here for you, and we will support you no matter what it is that you need during this odd and strange time. So if you do want to come to services, again, we're going to do 9 and 10 on the 30th, and you do need to register. There's a couple of purposes there. We like to know how many people are going to come, and if someone does turn up sick, it'll help us with contact tracing, that we'll be able to let you know that someone at that service turned up sick so that we can all take appropriate precautions. Bring a lawn chair, masking is expected, and it will be good to see you then. All right. Other things that you need to know. We have sad news. Myrna Dudley passed away just over a year after her husband Roger passed. She has joined him and the rest of the family that has gone on before in the kingdom. And so we will be praying for Myrna's family and for all those who loved her in this time. The prayer list is always available to you. It is a sanitized version that doesn't have last names on it since it's online. If you have questions about who's who, just feel free to give the church a call and we will fill you in. We are being obedient here at the church to Governor Evers' mask order that when I'm not doing this or in my office, I'm wearing a mask. Everyone here in the church building, if they're not in their office, they're wearing masks. And so if you visit us, we're going to ask that you wear masks too, so that we can protect the most vulnerable in our midst. I'm still looking for someone to clean my gutters up here at Peace. Let me know. We're all in this together. Confirmands, we are within a few weeks of jumping into the new confirmation year. If you haven't let us know what you've finished and what you haven't, it is time. So there's going to be lots of grace this year. It is a crazy year. It's a crazy year at school. It's a crazy year in families. It's a crazy year at church. And it's a crazy year for confirmation. Let us know where you are. We'll make decisions about what that means with leaders of the church and your family, but it is time to get your work in so that we can continue. We are very near the end of our Luther Small Catechism class. We have a class coming up this next week, questions and answers about all things related to Holy Communion. So if there's something that you've always wanted to ask, check out the videos, send in a question, either email, phone, text, and I'll try to answer them on Wednesday. And then maybe we'll do a final wrap-up session, and then we'll pause for a week or two before we jump into the next thing. There are other announcements below. I commend them all to you. I commend our website to you. We've worked really hard and we've had some really wonderful help from members, especially Katie Bailey has done just a wonderful job being a resource for us. But if there are things that you want to know, probably you can find them on the website. Otherwise, we are standing by to answer any of your questions to help you in any way that we can. I want to thank you for your support of the congregations. I want to thank you for the ways in which you are contributing to the work of the gospel in this place. I want to thank you for the decisions that you make in your own life to be a fit ambassador and a peaceful neighbor. May God bless, protect, and keep all of us. Amen.